So now today we'll be discuss about a Linux operating system or a Unix operating systems. So Unix is a multi-user multitasking operating systems. So it is a started the Unix is 1965 by AT&T laboratories, and they are created by a con Thompson in 1969. It was written in the 100% of the C language, and it reduced in 1973. So, in the Linux, if we are talking about a Linux or a Unix, they have a many operating, many versions is there, many operators is there. So, that means you can see as a in the India, they are developed by the boss CDEC. So, CDEC can be developed as a boss operating system that can be work as a Unix. So, as you can know that are many Linux operating system version is there, and you can also see as a for example, Ubuntu, Red Hat, Fedora, SUSE, and there are many more version is there. And each have a many versions. For example, so today we will discuss about Ubuntu 18.4. So now we have logged in the systems. So now you can see in the my screen window, you can see as a login is open. So now how can we are pressing the username and typing the password. So, we have to active the users. Now, so when we are typing the passwords, so they can be open as same as it can. So, now you can see when we have login, we can see as a this is my desktop window is there. Now, which we are customized, you can change your display, your setting, your themes, and now you can see they are the some applications that we can be used for there. And now, in this toolbar, in the this Ubuntu version, you can see that is your application, it can show your application manager. If you want to update, you can use as a semantic packet managers or a Ubuntu software. They can be displaying as a MS Office. If you want to try to open them, that can work as a LibreOffice. You can rhythm box, that can be a media player, that can be sound is there. Then using as a file folder, that is file management. You can use as an internet or any more. Now, in the desktop, they can also display as a trash, that is known as a recycle bin. In the title bars, they can show as activities. So, you can typing, if you want to open any application, you have to type only the application name, and then it can be automatically is the coming and you have to open it. Suppose that if I want to open as a terminal, so we are typing the command TER. It can automatically come here. Now you can see this is terminal is coming. So when we are clicking as a double click is here, so we can open as a terminal windows. So now first of all, we have today in this chapter, so we have discussed about your basic commands in the Linux operating Linux and how can we customize your desktop and other modes. Okay. So now first thing is, now we are typing as a terminals, you can see that can be open is there. So, this is a my primary prompt. So, the dollar indicate for that can be your primary prompt. Now, I want to see the some command, so they can see the how many files in the my folder or where I am. So, we are typing as a first pwd. So, pwd command is generally used to display the present working directories. Now we are typing here, so they can be display the location where are you. Now I'm coming back for the desktop sessions, so we have to minimize the windows. And now you can see, if I want to customize the desktop, so what you can do in the Windows mode, you can click here. In the right clicking over, there can be working. So same as right click, I want to change the backgrounds, and we are click here, change backgrounds. So they can be open as a new windows, and they can be allowed to customize or setting your screen over there. So they can be open the settings as a control panel. So now you can see, this is your background, and if you want to change here, you want to change your the background. Now, so I want to change the background, so we are clicking here the backgrounds, and now you can see there are many background picture is there. So you can be select either one or either take as a buffer from there. So now in these times we are changing the hair. So we are taking as a heel is there, and now we are click select or a double click over there. Now you can see your background has been changed. So now you can see this is your hilly background is changing. So that can be two types of login screen. One is a background that can be when you are logging the Windows, that can be display, and another one when you are lock your system, that can be display your lock screen. And if you want to customize the lock screen, you can also, you can change as a, suppose that this time we are taking as a this picture, so now we are select them, and now you can see that can be changed. Now we can see how reflection is over there. So now we are log off the Windows. So we are pressing at the same command is there. Oh, sorry. So when we are log off, either you can, now you can see here. So the different background is there. Now again we are typing the password of this window. So there can be difference desktop background is there. If you want to turn off the PCs or turn off Linux, you can click in the right side at the top buttons. If you want to change your logout the session, you can click here the user. If you want to shut down your PC or turn off your PC, you can click here there or log the PCs. And now this gives you a speaker sign that can be display your volume level. And now in this Windows screen, if you want to see as a Wi-Fi, so that Wi-Fi or Internet Explorer, so if they are off on, so they can be display, so there are no bar connection is there. So if you want to customize the, so you can assign the IP address of the networks, so you have clicking over there and go to the wire setting, and you can be go to the IPv4 property and you can change your wire settings. So now the bar is on, so if you want to check here network, so you can click here the settings, and now you can assign as a IP address. So which IP you need, you can be go to the IPv4, IPv6, and now you can, so this is selection my automatic DSCP. So if you want to click as a manual, you can click a manual, and you have to assign the IP address. So if you are DSCP on, it no need for we are assigning the IP address, because we can be changed only the manually, and in the manuals they can be used to assign your IP address. So if you are selected as automatic DSCP, that means they can be automatic IP address should be generated, it take from the DSCP server. And if you want to assign as a particular IP, that is your fix your IP, you can assign your IP address, subnet mask or your gateway and DNS. And now you have to click here applies, so that can be working over there. So now I am cancel over there. Now so we are coming back to the command section, so we are writing as a some command, so we can use over there. So now in the Linux, first Because so where I am I, so we are typing as a pwd command that can be display as a percent working directories. Next command we can writing as a ls. So if you type as a ls, there can be list of the files can be displaying over there. So the how many files and directory that can be listing over there, you can see that. So now we are typing here as a fully structure. So we are typing here ls space minus l, and now you can pressing the enter key, ls space minus l. Now you can see that. So they can be display as a total 44 files is there. So they are some files, some directories is over there. And now in the each file have a sub, they can be display as a security. So they can have as a permission is the there, and now owner of the files and a group of the file and the bytes, that is a PID can be generated. It will take your date and time, it created date and time, and lastly they can be list of the file is there. So now first I want to creating as a file. So and the next command we are writing clear. So that is your clear your screen. So when we are typing as a clear, your screen will be clear. So now we are typing a commands. We are creating as a sample file. So type as a cat and pressing save plus greater than because input, and we are writing as ABC. And now we are pressing the enter key. We are writing the some text. This is my file. Now we are pressing as a control D. So we have to terminate and save. Now we can see my file is created or not. So we are writing here ls space minus l. So now you can see that we are creating as a ABC file of the given period of the time. So when we are creating as a ordinary files, so they can have as a given as a owner as a read and write permissions. Group can given as a read permission, and other can be allowed only for read the file. So as a owner, they can be read and write. Group and other can be only read the file. They cannot be change anything. Sorry. So now if I want to see the contents of the file, we are typing as a cat and we are writing the file supported at ABC. So now you can see the contents of the any existing file. So the cat command is used to as a creating a file, displaying the file. Now as well as we can also add the contents or a contents of the file. So what we are doing, we are writing as a cat and I append mode and type the ABC. Now so we are adding the some control. Good morning. Now pressing the control D. Now again we can change here. So type the cat space ABC. Now you can see I can adding something about contents. So there are the some basic or many commands there in the Linux. So thank you for. And now